Hi, welcome to GeeksforGeeks. In previous two videos, we discussed the properties of dynamic programming problems and the memoization technique. In this video, we will discuss the tabulation technique. In tabulation, we build the lookup table in bottom-up fashion, that is, we begin with solutions to the base problems and use them to calculate solutions to higher problems. And after the table is built, we return the required value, say table n. Let's understand the algorithm now. First, we enter the base value of I in the lookup table. Then, we run a loop that iterates over the remaining values of I. At every iteration I, we update the ith entry in the lookup table by using the solutions to the previously solved subproblems. After the loop ends, we return the value table n. As simple as that. Let's see how tabulation will work for our Fibonacci number problem. First, we enter the base values in the lookup table. Now, we run a loop for the remaining values of I in order to fill the rest of the table. We update table 2 as 1, table 3 as 2, table 4 as 3, and finally table 5 as 5. And done. So we see, unlike memoization where the program control was jumping from one function call to another function call, we got it all done in a single function call. This makes it look like tabulation might be better than memoization. But is it always the case? Since tabulation works in bottom-up fashion, it computes solutions to all the subproblems. However, it avoids performing multiple checks and lookups. When compared to the memoized version, this often saves function call overhead time. On the other hand, since memoization works in top-down fashion, it computes solutions to subproblems on demand. So in the worst case, memoization solves all these problems. But in the best case, it does not. But tabulation always solves all the problems. Also, sometimes the memoization solution is more intuitive to come up with than its tabulation counterpart. We will discuss these points in more detail later. Let's now shift our focus to the C code. First, we declare our lookup table. Then, we enter the base values. And then, we fill the table for the remaining values of I. Finally, we return the required value, fn. That's all for now. Thank you for watching.